Hello everyone and welcome back to Brooke's Beauty Bazaar. My name is Brooke and in today's video, I'm going to be talking about the unseen side effects of acne, aka your mental health. Roll the footage. Now, I do realize that a lot of you guys who are watching this channel have not gone through that severe level of cystic acne that I personally did, but this video is really for those of you who are going through it right now in the thick of it with your skin and you feel like there is no hope on the other side. I just want to encourage you, there is hope, and I think that all of us can relate to each other, severe or not severe with our acne, in that we have experienced some mental health issues related to our skin's condition. If you guys haven't seen my personal acne story, then I'm going to link it right now and you can check it out if you are curious. As a quick warning, this video is probably going to be ranty in some sections, but stay tuned because after I finish my rant, I'm going to give you guys a big dose of encouragement. Let's do this. So if you guys have watched my acne story, then you'll be familiar with the fact that I suffered from severe cystic acne from the age of 18 to the age of 25. And I always had acne even before that. It just wasn't quite as severe. And obviously I also had acne after that. It's just that the cystic factor had kind of diminished a little bit more. And truly, sitting here now at 30 years old, my skin has never been as clear as it is now after having discovered fungal acne. And if you guys are new to the channel and you don't know about fungal acne and my history with it, I am going to put a video right here that'll just help you better understand it. So I want to start out by telling you guys some of the ways that my acne was affecting my mental health during that time. So first off, at that time, I was so extremely embarrassed of my skin that I would always wear makeup no matter where I went and nobody was allowed to see me without it. However, that makeup really did very little to actually help me in regards to covering my acne. The very most it actually did for me was to make my skin tone slightly more even than it was. But underneath that makeup, it was still very obvious that there were tons of cystic crater-like pimples all over my face. And it was just so embarrassing. And I hated having to look people in the eye. And when I did look them in the eye, I felt like all they could see was the acne on my face. And if I was talking to them, I literally would just think, there's no way they're hearing me because they're so distracted by the terrible condition of my skin. Unfortunately, that thought was just solidified by the fact that at that time, I had family members and friends, and even on occasion, perfect strangers, not only commenting on my skin's terrible condition, but also then giving me unsolicited advice on how I should clear my skin. Those remarks obviously didn't help at all, and all they did was cause me to have this severe anxiety. I didn't want to see people in my day only because if they were to remark on my skin, it would send me into this downward spiral of depression that would set me off for the rest of the day, and I wouldn't be able to recover from it. Now, I can understand how in those people's heads, they thought that they were offering me this wonderful advice and being so helpful, but I really hated to hear from people who not only had really good skin, but also in their lifetime had really never experienced anything more than vanity acne. Clearly, you and I are not the same here. So when they would try to tell me things like, you should use Arbonne because I use it and I love it and it's so much more natural than everything else on the planet, or you should do this or that or whatever, or here's my routine, I just didn't have the patience to respond to them with the truth, which was that, person, I have tried so many thousands of products, I don't think you even understand, and none of them work for me, so I highly doubt the one you're recommending is even gonna touch it. And on top of that, I was already aware at this time that there were so many ingredients that I needed to actively avoid if I wanted to achieve clear skin ever in my life. But I didn't have the confidence to tell them, no, person, your recommendations are all wrong. Even though I knew it. And something that I think those people didn't understand is that when they are standing there in front of my face, actively pointing out my flaws, they are only reaffirming all the terrible things that I am already telling myself about my skin in my head on a daily basis. So instead of helping me, you're just reinforcing all of these negative thoughts that I have on this 24/7 loop in my head already, which are, I hate myself, I'm ugly, I'm terrible, I'm not worthy of love, I'm not worthy of friendship, no one's gonna ever take me seriously, and my life is awful. Now, I want to stop right here and just give you a trigger warning because I realize that some of you guys are actively saying things like that to yourselves on a regular basis, and I don't want you to spiral into that thought process right now. What I want to do is just tell you my personal experience with it and make sure that you guys know all those negative thoughts you're thinking right now are total lies. So because of that negative thought process, I really started to get more and more depressed, and I had kind of become a hermit by this point. And I had gotten to a really bad place with it where I would literally write letters to myself, just demeaning myself on purpose. So the whole thought pattern of doing that kind of stuff and all that self-destructive behavior, I was really partaking in it. So maybe you can imagine my debilitating depression and how much this was actually affecting my life. For starters, I was in college at the time. I was going to college and I was working as a barista, and literally those were the only two things I did. I just went to school to the classes only. I didn't socialize after, and I went to work because I had to make money, and just going to those two places took every ounce of energy mentally and physically that I could muster in a day. From there on, I was completely drained. It will not surprise you that I therefore would turn down any social invitation that I received at that time. It didn't matter what it was for or what it was to. I did not want to go, and I did not want to be around other people. My mom was constantly pushing me to be social and engage with other people because she knew that I was an extremely social person. In fact, leading up to that moment, there was never a time that I wasn't with my friends. I am super social to this day, and I love to be around people. I'm very extroverted. So now that I've explained how the mental health was affecting me socially and relationship-wise, I want to touch on how this held me back from my career and life goals. So it was back then that I first really got the desire to start a beauty YouTube channel and talk about beauty and everything that I knew about it on the internet. But because my skin was so bad, it was really hard for me to sit in front of a camera and talk beauty with everyone using products that really weren't that popular with other YouTubers at the time. And also because how are they gonna take advice from me when I'm someone who is shelling out beauty and skincare advice, but I have terrible skin, and I just felt like that's gonna make me look like a clown. How could those people ever take me seriously? All right, you guys, so I could really go on and on with this story because what really happened was just my depression continued to build upon itself and things got darker and darker as I went along. But instead, I really want to give you guys some practical tools that you can use if you're currently struggling with this dark kind of depression, and kind of give you some ideas of how you can start navigating through it. But before I do that, let's go ahead and hear a quick message from Past Brooke, and then I will meet you guys back on the other side and we will talk about those tools. Hey guys, Brooke here. I just wanted to drop a quick reminder that I struggled with acne for 17 years of my life, and it wasn't until I discovered fungal acne that I was able to clear my skin without the help of dermatologists, prescription drugs, harsh chemicals, or expensive products. If you want to find out the exact methods, products, and skincare routine I use to achieve these results, click the link in the down bar below to download my From Fungal Acne to Clear Skin guide. Just look for the green check marks. It's a one-stop, straightforward guide to help you navigate the world of makeup and skincare when you're dealing with fungal acne. And now, back to the regularly scheduled programming. All right, guys, welcome back. If you are still with me, I am so glad that you're here. And I know that that was a shameless plug for my product. However, I did just want to let you guys know that I have that guide. And if you suspect that you're suffering from fungal acne and you just want to learn more about it and kind of have a one-stop, straightforward solution, that guide is really gonna help you with it. One other thing I just wanna mention to you guys right now is that if you are struggling and a lot of this story has resonated with you from that mental health perspective and you're not feeling okay right now, if you want to leave me a comment, if you want to send me a private message, slide into my DMs on Instagram or email me, please feel free to do that. I would love to be a moral support for you right now because I know how much you need someone to talk to. I want this channel to be a place that you can express those emotions and then know that you are seen, loved, heard, and cared for. Now, here are four tips and tools that I have for you that can help you navigate your depression. So the first thing that I want to share with you guys is the fact that I'm a Christian and I truly believe in the power of prayer. And the whole thing about prayer is there's no prerequisite for talking to God. You don't even have to be a Christian to talk to God. All you have to do is cry out to Him and lay your burdens at His feet. Tell Him everything that you need to get off your chest. And in doing so, I think you'll be so surprised by the powerful peace you can experience just in knowing that He heard you and He also cares for you. Another thing that I would highly recommend, the second thing here, is to find another human being that you can actively engage with, confide in, and talk to on a regular basis about your life, the good, the bad, and the ugly. The reason this is so important is because you really need to practice being open and vulnerable with other people and breaking down walls and not being ashamed of yourself and trying to understand that that person who is investing their time in you, like you're investing in them, does care about you and values you just as you are right now. And by the way, you guys, I want you to know that right now, as you are in this moment, you are enough. You are worthy of love and friendship and companionship, and you are worthy of all of your wildest dreams. But in order to make those things really work out for you, you're gonna need to remain open and willing to share yourself and trust other people. Otherwise, you're gonna self-sabotage and not be able to achieve your goals as easily. Now, this third one is the most invaluable piece of information that you can ever learn in your life, and it's that you need to understand how much your thoughts are affecting your mental health on a regular basis. So every single one of us is actually talking to ourselves every step of the way through our day. We have this 24/7 hour loop of conversation going on in our brain where it's just us alone with our thoughts. And the problem is that when you're telling yourself negative things all the time, 24/7, that habit becomes so hard to break because you're so down on yourself and you just don't believe anything good and you're not able to really reason with yourself. So what you need to do to fix this issue is learn how to stop that pattern, interrupt it, and reframe yourself. In order to do that, all you really have to do is when you're in one of those moments, catch yourself, actively listen to yourself saying, you are worthless, or whatever it is that, you know, insert terrible thought here, and say, Brooke, stop, or whoever, whatever your name is, stop. And then from there, you've interrupted your thought pattern, and now you're gonna say, okay, why am I thinking I am worthless? And is it true? Am I really worthless? And you're probably looking at me like, Brooke, duh. Yes, I am worthless. And I feel you because I used to validate myself all the time in that way. But you really need to work on getting honest with yourself and being accepting of the fact that, hey, you just stopped your bad thought pattern and interrupted it. Congratulations to you. Now, what can we do to change it? And remember, if one of your friends reached out to you because they were dealing with an issue like this, would you sit there and tell them, yeah, you really are crap and I really do hate you and no one will ever love you? No, obviously not. You would tell that person, I love you so much. I love you unconditionally. And I am here to support you through this time and see you on to a better future. I know you would. So you need to learn to treat yourself with the same amount of grace and kindness that you do those other people in your lives. So the fourth tool that I want to share with you guys is journaling. Journaling is so powerful for those of us having terrible mental health problems because it allows us to really relax our brains and kind of focus in, and then you can get all of that negativity out of your body just by writing it down. And then at the same time, it really helps you to start processing and working through problems and then coming up with solutions to them as well. I really think journaling is just critical thinking. So if you think about your typical journal entry, it's typically, at least for me, Dear Journal, here's my list of grievances. It is innumerable. There are so many of them, and here's all the terrible things that are happening because of them. And then after about, like, you know, depending on the rant, the third or fourth section of your journal really becomes this way that you're problem solving for yourself, and you're saying, no, I'm not gonna let this get me down anymore. Here's how I'm gonna change tomorrow. Here's what I'm gonna do differently. And it helps you to just reason and gain perspective. So I think it's super impactful. Now, if you're not someone who really likes journaling, because not everyone does, you can always record yourself, make a video diary. So I would really love to go on and on with all the really great tools and books that I've read that have helped me in my mental health journey. But I will tell you that the one thing I know first and foremost about mental health is that it is a constant work. And I also was hoping that you guys would try to share something. If you've gone through mental health struggles and you have a really good tool that has helped you, share it in the comments below, because you never know how much it's going to impact someone else. So there are actually no products to link in today's video. However, it's going to be a little bit different down there, because I am going to link a few of my favorite self-help books and journals that can really help you get started on this mental health journey if you are looking to recover from your severe depression. And make sure you guys send me a message, talk to me if you need someone to reach out to. I am here for you whenever you need the help. Don't forget, come over to Instagram @BrookesBeautyBazaar. Say hi to me, because I hang out over there every single day.